Make your own dinosaur jump game with MIT App Inventor. The Dinosaur Jump Game is a fun and interactive mobile game where a dinosaur runs across the screen and must jump over obstacles, like cactus plants, to survive. If the dinosaur hits a cactus, the game ends with a sound and shows a game over image. The game is created using MIT App Inventor, a visual programming tool that allows kids and beginners to build mobile apps using blocks. In this game, timers are used to animate the dinosaur, move obstacles, and simulate jumping. Players can tap the dinosaur to make it jump, and try to survive as long as possible by avoiding the obstacles. Inserting images and audio files. To upload the dinosaur and cactus images and the game underscore over dot mp3 sound to your MIT App Inventor project, follow these detailed steps. At the bottom right of the screen, locate the media section. Click the upload file button. Select your dinosaur image file from your computer. Click OK to upload it. Repeat these steps for the cactus images and game underscore over dot mp3. Here's how to design the user interface of Dinosaur Game app in MIT App Inventor. In the Designer view, click on the Screen 1 component at the top of the components list. In the Properties panel on the right, make the following changes. Align horizontal center. This centers all visible components horizontally on the screen. Screen orientation landscape. This sets the game to display in landscape mode, wider screen. Title Dinosaur underscore Game. This sets the title of your app window, seen on the top bar of the device. In the Designer tab, go to the Drawing and Animation drawer. Drag and drop the canvas component onto your screen. In the Properties panel, configure it. Width, fill parent. Height, fill parent. Background color, interface underscore game.jpg. In the Designer tab, go to the Drawing and Animation section. Drag and drop an image sprite onto your canvas. In the Components list, select the new image sprite 1 and rename it to Dinosaur. In the Properties panel, click the Picture field. Upload or select your dinosaur image, e.g., dinosaur1.jpg. Set the height and width appropriately, e.g., 50 by 50 pixels. In the Designer tab, go to the Drawing and Animation drawer. Drag and drop another image sprite onto your existing canvas. In the Components list, rename this sprite to Cactus. In the Properties panel, click the Picture property and upload, select your cactus image, e.g., cactus1.jpg. Set its height to match your design, e.g., 80 pixels. In the Designer tab, go to the User Interface drawer. Drag and drop a button onto your screen. You can place it below or above the canvas. In the Components list, rename the button to Reset. The Reset button allows the user to restart the game after it ends. In the designer view, go to the sensors drawer. Drag and drop four clock components onto the screen. The clock one component animates the dinosaur running and changes between three images repeatedly. The clock two component simulates the jump up movement when the dinosaur jumps. The clock three component simulates the fall down movement of the dinosaur after a jump. The clock four component moves the cactus from right to left and changes cactus image for animation. In the designer view, go to the media drawer. Drag and drop the sound component onto the screen. Program the application. In the procedures drawer, click to procedure do and name it reset. The reset procedure is used to restart the game after a game over. It resets the positions, images, and timers. Go to the block section, click on screen 1 and drag the block when screen 1.initialize do. Inside this block, call the reset procedure. Go to the block section, click on the reset button component, drag and drop the event block when reset, click do. Inside this block, call the reset procedure. Go to the block section, click on the clock 1 component and drag the block when clock 1.timer do. Inside this event, add blocks to animate the dinosaur by switching between different images to simulate walking or running. Go to the block section. Click on the dinosaur image sprite added in the canvas. Drag the event block when dinosaur touch do. This event allows the player to make the dinosaur jump by tapping on it. It simulates the jump action, helping the dinosaur avoid obstacles like the cactus. Go to the blocks editor. In the left panel, click on the component named clock 2 and drag and drop the block when clock2.timer do. Clock 2 handles the jump up, and when max height is reached, it disables itself and enables clock 3 to make the dinosaur fall down. Go to the Blocks Editor, click on the Clock 3 component in the left panel and drag this block into your workspace when clock3.timer do. Inside this block, increase the Y position of the dinosaur to simulate the falling down after the jump. In the left sidebar, click on the clock 4 component and drag this block when clock4.timer do. Inside it, decrease the X position of the cactus to make it move leftward. The clock4.timer changes the cactus image dynamically. Go to the blocks editor, click on the dinosaur sprite in the left panel and drag this block into your workspace, when dinosaur.collided with. Implement the necessary blocks to disable all clocks. Play gameover.mp3. Show the first image of the dinosaur. And show the reset button. To create an APK file, Android application file, from your project in MIT App Inventor, follow these simple steps. At the top of MIT App Inventor, click on Build Android App.app. If you chose the QR code, you'll see a QR image you can scan. If you chose Download, the .app will be saved on your machine. For more details, you can see my website robotique.site. For more details, you can see my website robotique.site robotic guide.